The list of terrorists accused of plotting or carrying out attacks against the U.S. is long and getting longer.
Well, the Pentagon's top lawyer basically talking at Oxford University is just warning people that just because you're seeing the U.S. pull forces out of Afghanistan doesn't by any means mean that the reason why they went in, which is to go after al-Qaeda in the first place, has softened at all. And Suzanne, you know that there are still, it's been the administration's consistent statement that al-Qaeda Corps has really been degraded.
Your U.S. soldier has not gave us any information or money. He shall not die. Allah is great. Allah is God. Allah Akbar!
However, there's still a significant threat from its affiliates, AQIM, al-Qaeda in the Islamic Maghreb, operating in North Africa, as well as al-Qaeda in the Arabian Peninsula, operating in Yemen. And because Jed Johnson says this is an unconventional war, where you don't have your normal enemy and surrender procedures that you would like wars in the past, that you're going to continue to see a lot of those controversial tools used in this war. One of those, of course, as we know, is the use of drones, particularly in going after these affiliate members.
We know that earlier today there was a rocket attack on an American base in southeastern Baghdad. It was three rockets that were fired from a Kia pickup truck. And we know so far that five Americans have died and several more have been wounded, including what could be at least a dozen U.S. soldiers.
And any idea, you know, who is behind this?
No, we don't know who's behind it, and no one has claimed responsibility yet. But the Americans have said over the past few months that they expect violence to increase against them as they prepare to withdraw by the end of the year. So this sort of fits that pattern.
And this comes at a time, I believe, when the Iraqi government is also considering whether or not to, what, allow Americans to stay longer with a military presence?
Correct. The Iraqi government is currently debating what they want the United States to do after the end of the year. And on one side, you have the Shiites who don't want the United States to stay, but there are many other Iraqis who do.
All right, we got to defend our checkpoint here. There's a Osama bin Dani that's expected to be here. He's Allah Akbar. You know, he's one of those crazy fanatics, so we just got to remember to stay safe. Let's do our jobs and let's get it done. Here we go.
Yes.
Here we go. Oh, my bad. Remember, don't fire unless you're fired upon.
Ready, you should do that fire and move thing. It's like three guys stay down and they start firing and like two guys stand up and run back while they're firing. And then they run like 10 yards. Those guys that defend, get down, they aim, and the other guys run.
I know what you're saying.
Yeah. It's like a retreating tactic to get in.
Dude, the fucking jihads are like sand people. From Star Wars.
That's what my dad called him.
Really?
He didn't call him that though. Really.
What does he call him?
Fucking sand, dude.
The sand niggas? Alright. This is like the checkpoint right here. Try not to shoot the car or the truck.
Jason, when you yell out, I'm hit, like when you get hit and stuff, like you're actually...
Yeah. Did you see that?
No.
That cat.
Oh, I see it.
Sector 6, we have a possible Lima Charlie. We have 3 jihads on the road, unconfirmed if they are hostile.
Hey, 25 Henry, return your previous frequency, please.
Hey, move along, people!
Told you to move, not stand there! Move, stupid!
Fuck your Allahu Akbar! Hey, they got guns, get down! Hey, I need eyes on this guy over there. Hey, JD, let's go. Yeah, search him. Contact! You hit? Fuck. Oh. Hey, fall back, fall back! Yo, Deathridge, you live?
I'm up!
Left side!
Hey, I got one! Hey, make sure you watch that left side! Hey, go back to respawn, Walker! Go check on our other guys. Hey, left side, left side! 25 meters!
Everybody fire!
Kill them!
100 down!
You guys good? You guys good?
I'm up!
Hey, yo, Marcus, you good?
They're taking fire! I can't move, they got me pinned in the bushes!
Contact! Contact!
Hey, I need cover! Medic!
Medic! Hit!
Medic!
Medic!
I got 2 Archies down! Hit! I need a medic! Thank you.
Echo 6-9, we're gonna need close air support, over.
AC-130 standing by. Repeat, AC-130 standing by.
Don't let him cross the border! Left side, left side! Checkpoint Alpha! Reloading! Moving. Fuck. JD, watch this side for me. We got it. JD, I'm down. Watch this side. He got one coming up. Fuck. No, I got one. Good. Got Brandon coming up that side. You respawning? Hey, moving!
We're already down.
Okay. Moving this side. Do we have anybody?
Well, ISAF confirm at this point that two of their personnel were shot dead on the grounds of a base in southern Afghanistan. They say that one man they believe to be an Afghan soldier and another man a civilian who could well have been a teacher, perhaps teaching English to Afghan soldiers on that base, opened fire, killing these two ISAF personnel and were then shot dead by the other soldiers on the base. We understand from an Afghan official, though, that these soldiers were Americans working in an area called Zareh in Kandahar, and that apparently this teacher, as far as they're aware, and bear in mind this information is always very preliminary and it can change over time, as far as they're aware, this particular teacher was in fact some sort of plant by the Taliban who'd been there for approximately a year at this point. The motivation's unclear, but all of this feeds into this last week's worth of similar incidents. Two soldiers shot dead on a base in the east about a week ago from today. Two senior American officers shot dead in the securest part of the Interior Ministry in Kabul on Saturday. Six dead Americans in the past week, all from men apparently in Afghan army uniform turning their weapons upon them. The only actual casualties, very sadly, in the past week ISAF have sustained have been from incidents like this, and it's really going to play into that whole feeling of trust that Afghan soldiers have with the Americans they work alongside. Their cooperation so vital so American troops can start to go home.
And Nick, is this being tied at all to the Quran burning and the tension that is still existing because of that?
I think inevitably there will be some people drawing connections, although there's no statement to that effect from anybody. In fact, while ISAF won't comment on their ongoing investigation, the Afghan official we spoke to said this was somebody who'd been put in that role by the Taliban a year ago, so perhaps they chose to strike because of this Afghan wave of anger at the Quran burnings, but it doesn't appear that this was an operation put into effect because of that incident. But still, it's going to feed into that wider sense of anger and distrust growing in Afghanistan now.